maybe season 10 or later on, but definitely not at this point. It got to, you know, Clive represents the people. He represents us, you know. So I think it's fun to have this world existing underneath his nose that he has no idea about. So I think it'll be cool to milk that for as long as it works. I think eventually he's gonna have to, you know, so many strange things happening around him. How he's gonna take it is gonna be really, really interesting. I always say it's one of those things where, you know, there's no way he would think, you know, zombies, you know, because the way zombies are represented on television, and they don't talk, you know, they don't communicate, and so that's why he would never ever just assume, wait a minute, you're a zombie. You know, that's a little, he would never go there first, because we would never let him go there first, you know?
But don't you think, with all the zombie movies around, doesn't it make your character seem stupid? He doesn't realize something is off.
I think he may realize something is off, but I don't think he'll think voodoo first or something, you know, before he goes to zombies. Because if you think of zombies and Walking Dead and Night of Living Dead, these aren't functioning zombies. Zombies don't have jobs, you know, they work at the morgue. And so that's exactly what he's dealing with why that code can exist. Because not only, you know, there's a lot of people who don't know. So it's,
So how do you think this character will react?
And
do you think
it's going to
find out in season
10? I don't know. I don't think he'll find out. I think that's a little too soon. Obviously, it's not my decision. It's Rob's and Diane's decision. But I think if he does find out, I think it's going to be a real world reaction. If you find out someone right next to you is a zombie for you, you'd be like, what? You know, so I think he'll trip. Yeah, I think so. I think it's going to create, and I think also another factor is the fact that he's on the major. The major being involved in, you know, the depth of, you know, his lieutenant. You know, so I don't think Clive will let that, he's going to let that go. It's going to be interesting what happens with that. They haven't told me about where that goes, but I know it just doesn't go away. So that may create some kind of conflict between Clive and Liv. But at the same time, you know, they do have their friendship precedes that. And, you know, I think it won't stop them from still solving cases and more victims. I think so. I think Clive is good that, you know, we can, you know, for example, you know, I think he's the one to offer new things to live those about, because, you know, it'll be a problem. So he's letting that slide. You know, even until, you know, when Lowell was killed, and he's concerned for him. So he does have bias, he is biased, and Clive is a Goodwin. How he got his bad reputation on the cover, which is why he worked by himself, because he was going across the line in order to take down this gang, and then, you know, beating up his real partner at that particular time, you know, and it did give him a bad reputation. He's just like, I can work with a guy who's for his job, and for justice, me, you know, fuck me, he's gonna do whatever it takes.
There was a moment where we thought you might have been a dirty cop.
Yeah.
How would you have felt if that was a character?
Oh, I wouldn't have liked that. Obviously I would have played it. I think it would have been fun. I'm glad it, I love that Clive was honorable. So I think it would have taken away some of that honor and honesty and dedication. luckily they didn't do that. You know, I just told that he was committed to do whatever he needed to do to on that particular case. And obviously what he did in that particular case, the extent he went to, didn't give him that bad reputation. But it was never, you know, you never look at him like this is a bad guy. You know, he just had to do what he had to do in order to save his life and his partner's life. I mean, I love Comic-Con because Comic-Con is pretty much a celebration of art, of comics, of talent, of film, and of fantasy. It's infectious. You know, I think it's a beautiful thing, a collective of people coming together, and you realize you're not alone in loving these things and these characters. So I think it's been great. It's been an honor.
Did you consider yourself a nerd or anything? Or could it be something?
Yeah, I'm more of a tech nerd. I build computers and I can build websites and I can do all this. I'm an editor, so I'm more of a technology geek. My castmates can tell you.
See, I can talk to you all day.